Let's do this. Yo, 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 what is good, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Thank you guys so much for stopping by once again. Today, you should already know the vibes. It is Wednesday, the day before the Supreme drop, so I'm here to do another dropless review for you guys. This time around, it is for week 17, and I'm not gonna lie, I am pretty excited about this week. Obviously, we have a big item dropping, that being the Bandana Boss Logo t-shirts. There's also the winter tees, which in my opinion are kind of mediocre, but it is what it is. Some of them are pretty dope, but we'll get into that a bit later. Also, in this video, I am going to give you guys a pretty in-depth how to cop guide. That's going to be at the end of the video after I review the drop list. I would definitely suggest waiting for that because there are some important bits of information that I do not think you guys want to miss out on. But yeah, again, we'll get into that later. Before I get into the actual drop list review though, I do have to mention a few things. I'll try to make it quick. I know the drop list is not that small and I don't really want to make this video too long, and I also want to get to the how to cop guide as well. But if this is the first time someone on my channel or checking out any of my videos, please support the kid. Hit that subscribe button for me one time. I definitely do not think you guys will be disappointed in the content. I really do have content like this for you guys every day. I practically have been uploading every day for like the past 4 months. So please, if you guys don't mind, if you guys like content like this, please hit that subscribe button. Join up Ugly Gang. It'll definitely be appreciated. Also, if you guys are not aware, I do have my own resale platform at Item Secured. It's also a website, itemsecured.com. I just recently updated the website. Actually, I did that before I started to record this video. I would definitely suggest going and checking that out because I do have some steals. And if you guys want to, you can always reach out. We can definitely negotiate on anything you guys want. So please go check that out, ASAP Rocky. It'll definitely be appreciated, and I do not think you guys will be disappointed in that. Also, lastly, while you guys are at it, go follow me on my personal Instagram. My personal Instagram is pretty fucking elite, as I say all the time. I have a lot of fire content on there, and I also have a lot of fire content coming. So please go check that out. I do not think you guys will be disappointed in that either. But enough of all that stuff, enough of those plugs. Let's get into the actual video. Let's get into this drop list. I'm gonna swap over to my setup, and as always, let's break this down for you guys. All right, let's do this. Let's see what this week is popping off for. I'm going to try to make this quick because this drop list is pretty large and there's a lot of pretty much garbage on this list. I don't really want to waste a lot of time, and I do want to get to the how to cop guide because that's probably what you guys are mostly interested in. So as always, I'm going to start at the bottom of the list, work from the least liked items, and go from there. There is no prices as well this week, so that's pretty unfortunate. I'm going to try my best to estimate the prices in my head. I usually am not that far off, but let's see how that goes this week. Let me pull up Supreme Community. Let me throw you guys on the screen. Let's pop this off with this striped rib long sleeve knit polo. That is a piece of garbage. Moving on, we have the ARC logo quilted flannel shirt. That logo on the back is not bad, but still big trash if you ask me. That is going to brick. Moving on, we have the checkerboard beanie. This piece is nasty as well. The logo on that is nasty, and also the colors that they chose. Supreme, what the fuck are you doing? Next, we have the Polartech pants. We saw this supposed to drop another week. I believe it was like week 15, and we did not get it. This, they should have just thrown it away. They should have just scrapped the entire piece because that piece is trash and it's definitely going to brick. Not only do they fit badly, but they attract everything and their mom to these, so I would definitely suggest not getting those. But moving on, we have the thermal zip up hooded sweatshirt. Another just nasty piece. Like, what the fuck? Who the fuck designed that? Jesus. Next, we have the checkerboard puffy jacket. To be honest, I'm not gonna lie, I might be alone on this, but I was really looking forward to this when I saw it during the preview. To be honest, I still like it. I just wish that it wasn't double ARC logo. Maybe just this one on the front without the one on the back. I think it would have been a little bit better. But regardless, I like this piece. If you're not a fan of loud pieces, this might not be for you. But if you don't mind, you know, being a little bit out there with the stuff that you wear, this is definitely a pretty nice piece. As far as the best one, I think it's the red and black one. The other two are not bad, but I think that the red and black one is a lot better than both of those. Regardless, this is definitely not going to resell. With the box logo t-shirts dropping and the winter tees dropping, this is just going to brick. So if you are looking to cop it for resale, I would suggest against that. But for personal, I do not think that it's a bad jacket at all. Moving on, we have the contrast stripe beanie. This is pretty all right. It's nothing crazy. Am I gonna cop this? No. Do I think it'll flip? No. Do I think it'll sell out? Yes, because you know, it's weather appropriate right now. But the blue one is not bad. The black one obviously is not bad. The other three I would say are pretty trash. Maybe that blue one or that black one has potential to the resell, but do I think that they're worth it? I would say no. But if you like it for personal, I guess you can pull the trigger on that. Moving on, we have the ear flap new era. Me personally, I don't like these type of hats, but I know that a lot of people are a fan of these, especially when it comes to Supreme. If you guys want to pull the trigger on this, I do not think that it's a bad idea. Just look at how the Ushanka faux fur hat is doing. These type of hats just do well, so I can see why people want to go for it, but me personally, I'm going to have to sit out on that one. Up next, we have the clown tee, the first out of the winter tees. I'm not going to go over the tees in this video because I did a whole video on them yesterday, so if you guys want to see my resale predictions or just me go in-depth reviewing these tees, I would say go check that video out. It's pretty in-depth and it's probably a lot more specific than I can get in this video, so yeah, I would say just go check that out. But we have the clown tee, the money power respect tee, the diver or the diver tee, I'm not really sure how to pronounce that, but there's a couple more. If you guys want to, of course, go check that video out. Moving on, we have the face mask polo tech camp cap. This is pretty weird. It's not a bad piece though, but it's definitely not for everybody. Like me personally, I can't wear this. I wear my hats backwards and it does not look like I'll be able to get away with this. So that's quite unfortunate. I would say that it's a pretty unique piece, but do I think that a lot of people are going to be super overly excited about it? No. Will it resell? Maybe in this like black colorway or even the yellow colorway, I can see that as well. But I don't think it's worth it, to be honest. Just a week again when there's the box logos dropping, this is going to get overlooked. So this will probably retail for about $55, maybe $60. And I don't think it's worth it, but if you guys want to take that risk, I guess you guys can go ahead and do that. Moving on, we have the Polotech half-zip pullover. Again, we were supposed to see this during, I believe, week 15, and for some reason, it got delayed. This is not a terrible piece. It's not a great piece. It's a pretty, decent piece. If you guys are in need of outerwear, this is not a bad piece to go cop. This will probably retail for about $158, $148, somewhere around there. I do not think it'll resell, but once again, if you guys want to pull the trigger on it, I don't think that it's a terrible piece, but the majority of people will probably end up passing on that. Up next, we have the bridge tee, which again, I went over in yesterday's video. Then the eat me tee, which is probably the fan favorite among t-shirts. Then we have the bandana fleece neck gaiter. This piece is, I would say it's gonna break. This is not worth it. I know that everybody is into like these paisley and these bandana designs this season, but I don't think that this piece is going to do well. Hence, I don't think that it's worth going for. I just don't think that it's that wearable and that usable of a piece. So a lot of people will probably pass on it. If you guys want to take the risk though, I don't think that it's going to do much. I would suggest against that, but I guess you guys can make the decision as well. For personal, I don't think it's a terrible piece, but me personally, I'm going to pass on that. Moving on, we have the bite tee, which again, yesterday's video, go check that out. The aguila tee, however you pronounce that, again, yesterday's video, that is another tee that I want though for myself. Then we have the snow tube. I would love to see the actual picture of the snow tube. Unfortunately, it's retailing at 110 buckaroos, which will probably make it a brick. Personally, I'm not gonna go for this. I just don't see a reason for me to go for this. I'm not going to use it, and I definitely do not think that it's going to resell, and I definitely don't want to have a snow tube sitting in my apartment. So I'm going to pass on this. If you guys want this for personal, I don't think that it's a bad accessory. I actually think it's a pretty fire accessory. But of course, if you can only make use of it, for those of you guys who are just looking to resell it, I would definitely advise against that. I do not think that this is going to do anything, but once again, Supreme is out here with their pretty unique accessories. Lastly, we have the slapper of the week, the big hitter. We have the bandana box logo t-shirts. These tees are insanely fire. I know that we have gotten in the past a paisley box logo, and this is a complete remake of that. I know a lot of people are upset about it, which rightfully so. I can definitely understand why. Hopefully this isn't a trend that we see going forward with Supreme just retroing past designs, because that'll definitely suck, and it'll definitely potentially kill some of the prestige behind the brand. But regardless, this t-shirt is fire. I'm excited about it. I hope you guys are excited about it as well. This will definitely resell for a lot of money. It'll definitely be hard to cop. I don't know about you guys, but I have a couple colors in mind. I have this brown one that I really want. That yellow one is a hitter. That black one as well. I really like how that black paisley pattern sits on that black t-shirt. So I might go for that one. But of course, the big hitters will be that white one, the pink one. This gray one is also going to be a pretty coveted one as well. But to be honest, I don't really have much to say on these. You guys should already know the deal when it comes to these t-shirts. I'm going to give you guys a how to cop guide. So let me take you guys off the screen. I don't really want to waste a lot of time, so let's get into it. Let's see how to cop one of these bad boys. All right, let's get into how to cop one of these bad boys. I know a lot of you guys probably have a lot of concerns regarding tomorrow's drop, and to be honest, I do as well. I always get nervous right before a drop. I don't know why, but I really, really don't like it. In this section, I am going to try to alleviate you of some of those stresses and maybe, you know, help you guys out in securing one of those box logos. First and foremost, I would say if you guys are going manual, you got to have an autofill, whether that's on Filler, on mobile. The Filler app is great. It not only works for obviously copying stuff online through the Supreme site, it also is really, really good for signing up for in-store. That's how I'm always able to, you know, get into the in-store sign-up. Even though I don't get selected, I do always get that confirmation page, and Filler is definitely my way to do so. Also, if you guys are going on desktop, I would suggest a couple of autofills. Filler does work on desktop, but sometimes it does get flagged, so I would say that that's probably not the best one to choose. There's that little lightning bolt autofill. That one is my kind of my go-to. I know that a lot of people had problems with that last week, but that one is my preferred one when it comes to desktop. Also, you have Chrome's autofill settings, which are also pretty good. The problem with Chrome's autofill settings is that sometimes it does not fill everything that you need. So sometimes you might find yourself having to go back and fill out the like your address line or like your apartment, or it's just sometimes it's just really random. It's really good in that sometimes it does come through clutch and it does work, but there are some times where you might get caught up and have to fill out something, and that can definitely you know, lead you to an L. Also, as of late, a lot of people have been reaching out and asking me, how does the little button on Supreme's website work? The little remember my information button. To be honest, that is a really good option when it comes to filling out your information pretty quickly on the Supreme site. The only problem is that, once again, just like the Chrome autofill settings, it does not fill out everything. But nonetheless, as far as like getting your billing information and your shipping information down, it does work for that. When it comes to that though, you do have had to have placed an order prior. Come Thursday morning, if you are going to use that method, I would suggest having your credit card information copied and ready to be pasted, because it definitely is not going to save that. It actually might be a good thing that it's not going to fill out your credit card information, because sometimes Supreme's website does flag, you know, when it does autofill everything. So maybe just by having to input your credit card information, your CVV, and your expiration date, it won't flag you as a bot or flag you for violating the terms of service, which is how you get the TOS violation. But regardless, that is a really good method. If you guys want to use that, I can suggest that as well. But also, another way of how to cop one of these bad boys is obviously using a bot. If you don't have a bot, I would suggest you reach out to one of maybe a cook group or a monitor group and maybe try to fill out some slots. A slot is a great, great way of securing an item. Sometimes you do have to pay more, or actually most of the time you do have to pay a little bit more than retail, but it's still a great way of securing an item and not paying market price. So if you guys are planning to resell it, you can still make some profit over the you know, the price that you're paying, which is great. Sometimes slot users are using the best bots on the market, so it's a pretty good chance that you end up securing one that way. But in times that they don't secure it for you, most people would offer you a refund, so it's not like you're losing much. If you hit, you will get the item and you probably pay like $50 above. If you don't hit, you get your money back and no harm done. So if you haven't already, I would definitely suggest reaching out to your cook group and trying to get in on some slots, because that could definitely come through clutch. If you're not in a cook group, I would suggest trying to get in one. It might be a little difficult now and it might be last minute, so you might be a little assed out for this release, but going forward, I would definitely suggest at least getting into one cook group. The services that most cook groups provide are pretty important and are pretty clutch. So yeah, I would definitely suggest getting into one of those. Another way to cop one of these bandana box logo t-shirts is obviously paying resale. I would say that the best time to buy one of those box logo t-shirts would be about 4 or 5 days after the release, just like it is now after the box logo hoodies. It's just the time when most people who've ordered online are getting theirs in and are looking to sell. So it will not only be the most on the market, it'll also be people competing with each other's when it comes to prices, so you might be able to find a pretty good steal. In fact, I found a pretty good steal on one of my hoodies that I really wanted. You guys will see that very, very soon in an unboxing. But if you guys are looking to pay resale, if you're a reseller and you're looking to flip a flip, I would say wait till like maybe Tuesday, Wednesday of next week. That that'll probably be when the tees will be the cheapest, and I'm sure that you can walk away with a pretty good steal. But lastly, of course, my favorite way of copying one of these bad boys, if you live by a store, go to the store, try to negotiate with somebody who just picked it up. I'm telling you, it works all the time. You can walk away with a steal. You can get a really, really good price. A lot of people are simply just looking to get StockX payout. So if you're out there and you're waving, you know, a wad of cash in somebody's face and you're just looking to pay StockX payout, or maybe even a little less than StockX payout, I'm sure that you can probably not only find one, but maybe a couple of people that will, you know, let it go to you. And it's definitely a great way to secure one or a couple on the actual release date, which is great as well. But that is my video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys, you know, take away some valuable information. As always, good luck tomorrow. Good luck to me. Stay tuned to tomorrow's live cop, because that's definitely going to be a very, very interesting one. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Until next time, peace.